described and captioned media program. In the classroom and on the go. DCMP.org.
Media Education Foundation presents Default, the student loan documentary.
In my family, my mom didn't have the opportunity to go to college. And so for her, it was really important that my sister and I received an education. She sent us to private schools. When I went to public school, I went to one of the best public schools in Atlanta. And so the University of Pittsburgh offered me a great amount of money. And so I decided, I'm going to go. I've got financial aid. I've got a grant from the university. It's not going to be that expensive.
Matt, borrower.
I wanted to go to that film school forever. I was just so excited about it for years. I mean, it was my kind of my biggest dream. It was like somebody gearing up to try to get into Harvard Law. And I got my acceptance letter and I couldn't believe it. I was really on cloud nine. And no matter how much, at least at the time that it cost, I was just like, I'm just going to find a way.
All I know is that I wanted to go to school.
Robert, borrower.
Had student loans available to me, and I took them out.
Anya Kamenetz, author of Generation Debt.
The birth of student loans actually happened by accident. In 1968, Reauthorization of the Higher Ed Act, there was a proposal to put in a tax credit for middle-class families that had two or more kids in college. And at the last minute, they came up with this counterproposal to do a guaranteed federal student loan instead of a tax credit. You know, they never would have thought that it would have grown to be the largest single source of money for tuition that it is now.
Student debt has become a much bigger issue.
Laura Asher, the Institute for College Access and Success.
It used to be that you could go to a state college, work truly part-time at minimum wage while you were in school and full-time in the summer. And if you came from a low-income family, you'd graduate without debt. Right now, that same student would have to borrow to get through school.
In a workshop, Eddie Irons.
Public institutions, state schools, tuition has risen really quickly, especially in the last 10, 15 years. And it used to be that grants that you don't have to pay back were available to cover 75% or more of the cost of an average four-year institution. That sounds like a fantasy to us now. It's completely switched. So we've gone from relying on grants to relying on loans, putting the burden of paying these huge costs onto students and their families.
Gregory Sendana, U.S. Student Association.
Receive a Pell Grant, a Cal Grant, work studying other federally funded financial aid programs, and I'm really happy about that. But at the same time, I still have to work three part-time jobs throughout the year. I worked almost 30 to 40 hours a week during the school year and more than 60 hours a week during the summer. And somehow I still ended up with more than $30,000 of debt after I graduated.
The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deafblind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a set of guidelines for adding descriptions and captions to media. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.